Hey everybody, welcome back to A Better Computer. My name is Matt, and this right here is Arc Search. Arc Search is the hot new thing from the browser company. It's their iPhone app, and it's not really for me. I don't particularly like how they've chosen to do things on the browser. It's not super useful to how I use a mobile web browser, and the Browse For Me feature, let's just say, it doesn't resonate with me. But I do still use Arc on the desktop, and I love it. I have tried to switch to other browsers just to make sure that I'm still using the right thing for me, and Arc still works perfectly for me. And today I wanted to show you some of the things that really stand out to me as the things that make me stick with Arc over something like Safari, which is built into all the computers I use, or Chrome, or Firefox, or any of those other things. I still use Arc, and I'm going to show you some of the things that I really love about it today. Okay, so we are on the computer now, and the number one thing that separates Arc for me is spaces combined with profiles. So, what are these? Profiles, we'll start there. If you go into profiles, you can have multiple profiles, and these are basically different accounts you're logged into, different settings. And so I have three profiles. I have one default, that's my normal stuff. I have YouTube for A Better Computer stuff, and I have work for work stuff, you guessed it. And I can set different search engines for these. I can be, whenever I'm in one of these profiles, I'm going to be signed into different accounts. So for example, when I'm at home watching YouTube, that's one Google account. When I'm managing A Better Computer, that's a different Google account. And when I'm at work, that's my work Google account. So I want to have different Google accounts signed in. That's a major pain in most other browsers. Profiles makes this super easy. And you can tie profiles to spaces. So I have these different spaces for home, YouTube, and work. And when I'm in each one of these, it's always signed into the right accounts. If I wanted to go ahead and edit this one, I can go ahead and, I can choose what profile I want it to be assigned to. So I can change this. This one's assigned to my default one. If I go into A Better Computer, my profile is YouTube. So they're connected to different ones. And it's just very, very nice to be able to always be logged into the right accounts in the right tabs. Next up is air traffic control, and this one is really interesting. So if you go into the app settings and go to links, go to the bottom, there's air traffic control, and this is, it's so good. I've got a couple set up here for examples, but basically I use Google Meet, we use Google stuff at work, and Google Meet is where meetings happen. So if I click a link for Google Meet, I want that to open in my workspace, and you can see I can choose which one of these I want it to open in. I want those to always open in my workspace. If I open a YouTube video, I always want that to be opening in the space that has my account that has YouTube Premium, so I don't have to watch ads and all that good stuff. And that's going to be my main space. And so this is how it works, right? So let's say I'm doing some YouTube work over here. I'm in this space, which is not the one that has my paid YouTube account. And someone sends me this link, says, hey, watch this video. I click it, and automatically Arc is going to load it in the, Arc is going to load it in this space because that's where I told it I always want to see these things loaded up. So I love this. You can get really powerful with air traffic control. This is only a small sample of the things that I have on my work computer, especially where I have a lot more complexity. There's a lot here that I use, but it helps me make sure that I'm always opening things in the right space. Now, this next one is really just for me. This isn't going to be relevant for everybody, but I really love the sidebar. That's kind of a whole other thing maybe I could talk about, but I love the sidebar. The sidebar really works with me. I tend to have more horizontal space to work with than vertical space, so moving everything to the side has worked with my brain. But what I really like about this is that I present my screen a lot. I'm doing it right now. And when I do that, I can hit Command S and I can hide the entire UI. I just have this nice frame around it, and when I'm giving demos of software, this is super useful, and you just kind of move the mouse over here to see it come back up. I kind of wish there was a way to make it so this never came up, because sometimes I'm demoing and it doesn't, or it does show up and I don't really want it to, but just being able to show your web browser with no bookmarks, no distractions, just here's the frame of the web, I really like it. This next one, I don't really have anything to show, so I'm just going to say it real quick. I like Safari. I really do not like Safari extensions. The big example of this that I find really exemplifies the difference between Chromium and Safari extensions is 1Password. 1Password in Arc, in Chrome, in basically every browser is awesome for me. It works wonderfully. It works perfectly. It's super reliable. I've tried to use it in Safari. It is not reliable. It's like using a totally different app, and I totally understand why. If Safari is your main browser, 1Password might be driving you crazy. So yeah, and that's an extreme case, but in every example I found, the plugins that are available or the extensions that are available in Chromium browsers, I find more reliable and more full-featured than those in Safari. Then there are split views, and the split views are awesome at Arc. So basically, if I have this article open here that I'm reading, and I also have notes, and maybe I'm going to be taking notes on this, what I can do is instead of opening multiple windows and arranging them using macOS, I can just take this tab and drag it to the left, drag it to the right, drag it above, drag it below, wherever I want it. Let's put it to the side, and boom, now I have my notes here. I can resize seamlessly, really nice, and I can read this and take my notes at the same time. I love this. If I ever want to separate them, there's all the options here. I can split them. I can separate this from the split, and now they're individual tabs again. If I want to bring it in, we'll do the vertical split just to show that it's possible, even though this one isn't super useful to me. I can move this, convert to a horizontal split. There we go. So I can fix the error that I had. I love, love, love this. I find myself doing this all the time. And finally, one more thing to show today. Those are boosts. I think I've made a whole other video about boosts, but basically these are ways to customize how certain websites work. So let's say I'm on YouTube and I really never want to see shorts again in my life. I don't care about these. Let me get rid of them. Here's what you do. You go up to this little icon and then there's this icon here for boosts. So you can, make a boost. Cool. So what we can do is there's actually a bunch of things here, but I'm going to show you the zap function. So when you hit zap, you can scroll through the page and find the thing you want, highlight it, make sure it's highlighted in yellow. It looks like this encompasses all the shorts. Click it, and I want to zap this. And now that's gone. And so it's going to make it so that anytime YouTube tries to show me that section of the page, it's not going to show up. And boom, there we go. I've got rid of shorts. That's awesome. Great. Love it. I can also do things like force a dark mode on it. That looks a little weird, so I'm maybe not going to do that. You can change the color scheme of this. So let's make this kind of a, we'll make it just kind of a faint red background. You can change some things like the contrast. Let's make the contrast low or high or whatever. You can play around with this. You can change the font used for this. So you can change it to whatever you prefer. If you don't like what the web developer created, you can change the size of things. So change the default zoom, basically. You can also do your own custom CSS and JavaScript if you're comfortable with that. But yeah, lots to do in Boosts. This is just the tip of the iceberg, but using zaps to hide things on the page that you don't want to see, love it. So yeah, those are a couple things about Arc on the desktop that I still like, I still love, and I still get a lot of value from, even though their current kind of like Arc search thing that they're pushing everywhere isn't quite to my taste. But hopefully this video is helpful, helps you understand what I like about Arc, and I'll see you here next time. Bye-bye.